China forces 500,000 Tibetans into labor camps. 500,000. Guys, what happened to never forget, never again, we shall not forget? What happened to all that crap? Look at this. Look at this. Guys, you got, for all the people, for all the people that say, oh, Armin will never criticize Israel. Oh, we know who's being, we know who's buttering his toast. We know who he's serving. Why is Armin not criticizing Israel? Which I do. Here's a criticism for you guys. Where is Israel's condemnation of China, the country that's supposed to be the leading? Have they? I haven't noticed. Maybe correct me in the live chat. That last time I checked, maybe I didn't check thoroughly enough. Let's check right now. Okay. Let's check. Israel condemnation, China. Let's look. Nope. 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 Nothing. Correct me if I'm wrong. China has not been condemned by Israel, even though this is the closest thing we have had to this history that I cannot mention because YouTube's algorithm is moronic. You know what I'm talking about, the big H. These are the closest thing we're getting to in our lifetime to the memory and the history that Israel is rightfully trying to make sure that we all remember. But what's the point of remembering all of this? What's the point if we're not going to learn from it? What is the country right now that has the most to say about this? The most to say about all of this crap? Why is that country, which is Israel, not leading the world? Like, hey, world, we know what this is about. We have experience. Our people have experience with labor camps. You know, all of the Holocaust museums that we've funded all around the world, and rightfully so, because I agree, we should never forget. But you know what? What's the point of all of those if we now not use that memory to condemn this crap? Why are they not doing that? Why is Israel not at the front line of this? Yuval, tell me. Yuval, are you here in the live chat? You could tell me because Yuval is a Zionist. A good one. I mean, I'm a Zionist as well. If that's what it means, what I think it means. But again, I could criticize. I could criticize Israel for this. Yuval, are you here with me? Tell me if I'm wrong. Tell me if I'm wrong on this. Again, we're talking about Israel, a country that has not officially accepted the Armenian genocide as a genocide because they want to keep their relationship with Turkey. Apparently, the country that is telling everybody that never forget, here's a history, remember, remember. They apparently, their relationship with other countries matters more than the whole point of remembering all of this crap. Hershey is saying the internment of Japanese Americans also comes to mind. Yeah, but at least, but this is happening in our lifetime, guys. This is happening in our lifetime. Oh, you will say, see, guys, again, people say, like, oh, they think Zionists, they use that as an insult, okay? Again, Yuval is here. Yuval is a Zionist. Yuval is an Israeli Zionist, and Yuval is saying this is right. He's agreeing with me on that, okay? Do not say, do not, again, a lot of people think as soon as they hear the word Zionist, they're like, yeah, oh my God, you're a Zionist. Yuval is a Zionist, and he agrees that Israel is wrong on this, okay? And let's continue. Let's read the summary of this. What number was this? 8. Okay, let's read the summary. China is pushing hundreds of thousands of Tibetans into forced labor camps, mirroring a program in the western Xinjiang region. New evidence suggests that Chinese government now has a large-scale mandatory vocational, is that how you say that, training program in Tibet, pushing more than 500,000 rural laborers into recently built military style training centers in the first 7 months of this year alone. The labor camps are accompanied by enforced indoctrination, intrusive surveillance, and harsh punishment. Guys, the Orwellian nightmare, this is 100 times worse than what we could imagine, okay? Harsh punishments for those who fail to meet labor transfer quotas, according to the research by Dr. Adrian Zenz, amidst the pro-democracy crackdown in Hong Kong, the genocide of the Uighur Muslim people of Xinjiang, and the new evidence of Tibetan labor camps, the International Olympic Committee is being urged by global leaders to strip Beijing of the Winter Olympics. For people who don't think that this matters, the Winter Olympic stuff, it matters because they care about it. Even if you think like getting them stripped from Beijing Winter Olympics, even think that's not a big deal, the fact that it's a big deal to the Chinese government, that means it matters. That means that they need to suffer for these decisions, okay? People are like, oh, some people say, what about the athletes? What about the athletes that dedicate their lives to this and they're going to suffer? Why are you going to make them suffer? Guys, the athletes, what about these people? Look at this. I mean, I think this matters more than the athletes. Look at these forced labor. Yeah.
How many comments?
Hey, guys, I'm actually happy that this news got 200 comments and 300 engagement, and most of the engagements are angry. So I think our Atheist Republic community is becoming more mature, because we used to get a lot of comments of people like, good on China, do this, they're like this. And maybe because it's not the Muslims, but they're the Tibetans. Oh my God. Mostly jokes. Look, this is a horrible person. I was saying, nice, they could use the work. The reason why this got the most engagement is not because it's saying, like most of the engagement this got, it was a negative one. Anyways, let's move on to news. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay? If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But even there are people are like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we don't think you want this. We're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah, subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos, because you know, we do get demonetized, that's an obvious, on every one of our videos, so F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized, and that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized, what does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right, and all that, you know, on people's homepages, and that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow, so we need you guys to share our videos.